Sports Run. We're live at 7 o'clock here on Spectrum News. We are so excited that you're joining us here tonight. This Saturday night will be one you won't forget. Grab the tissues. So many emotional stories here behind me. As the Warrior Games 2019 get underway, you can see already action behind me. Yes, they're about to play a video. It's going to last about 3 minutes. And then the program gets rolling. The Warrior Games taking place here in Tampa. The host team, Special Operations Command, SOCOM, they are so thrilled to be hosting this year's game. You know, all branches of the military, maybe you can hear this a little bit, it's really quite loud here. All branches of the military are represented in the Warrior Games, and there are so many inspirational stories. Let me tell you, these athletes have gone through so much, many of them living through near-death experiences, having traumatic brain injuries, some may have limb loss, others have injuries that are not visible. They're struggling with mental health issues after combat, PTSD, very difficult emotional situations, but they are all here after fighting to recover, after getting help from each of their military branches and the Wounded Warrior programs that they each have for those members of the military. It is incredible, the stories of recovery. You're going to be featured on the floor at Amalie Arena here in Tampa tonight. I want to remind you, we do have team coverage from Amalie Arena. Our Dahlia Dangerfield and Chris Torello, they're both on the floor, and they're going to be talking to a lot of the families, friends, other local officials who are supporting the Warrior Games athletes. This is really going to be a fantastic night. I want to remind you, too, we are going to also see athletes not only from the American military branches, but from international teams. Five countries are presented here for the games. They are the UK, Australia, Canada, Netherlands, and Denmark. Their first time at the games, by the way. So, again, just a wonderful display here tonight of all of these athletes have overcome. You're going to see 300 athletes on the floor, each marching with their, you know, particular branch of the military that they're representing. All right, it looks like they're going to be playing a video. Why don't we go ahead and join in and listen?
Strength. You would not believe I'll fly, I'll run, I'll roll, I'll show for you. Yes, I'll die, oh, I've fallen, roll on. For you, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to present the 2019 DoD Warrior Games Parade of Athletes.
All right, so there.
A Category 7 hurricane by the name of Team Army has touched down at Tampa Bay. Get up and get loud for Team Army!
Being the largest branch of the military and also the oldest being founded in 1775. They were the first to walk out. They have 40 athletes, 10 of them are women. Now, for some of these athletes, you know, the road to the games began at the Army Warrior Care and Transition Program. And that's where recovering athletes are introduced to adaptive sports, the 13 adaptive sports they will be competing in here the rest of the week. And they also are introduced to reconditioning activities that are critical for them to get back, to bounce back. Now, the program for the Army Warrior Program, it actually takes a holistic approach to recovery. You can see some of these athletes you're watching live on television. Some of them, they are on wheelchairs. They need support. And that program that's provided by the Army helps them in different ways. They look at the person, the body, the spirit, career, family, to help these soldiers either return back to active duty or transition into veteran status. These athletes you're looking at on the floor right now, I want to introduce you to Captain Casey Turner. She's stationed at Fort Bragg, and she signed up for the most sports in Team Army, which is amazing. Listen to this. A total of 10 sports she's participating in out of 13. Now, she suffered a knee injury as she exited a tactical vehicle in 2017. But listen, 2018 was an amazing year for her. A year later, won 10 gold medals at a regional trial competition in Hawaii.
And on the seventh day when God rested, they overran his permit at Stolen Love, and they've been running the show ever since. Ladies and gents, Team U.S. Marine Corps!
And there you have it. The U.S. Marine Corps team coming out second, a young force. They are frequently deployed. They call themselves the nation's crisis response force and a force into readiness. Also a team with 40 athletes. In this case, 7 women are participating in this week's competitions. A big component of the recovery process for Marines is the Warrior Athlete Reconditioning Program, helping these athletes adapt through adaptive sports and reconditioning activities. Marines can choose to participate in daily activities, unit level competitions, and even larger scale events like this one, the Warrior Games. An interesting note about the Marine Corps team, only 4 members live in Florida right now. They're veteran Brandon Stevenson in Palm Bay, veteran Alec Bosinger Jimenez in Melbourne, veteran Beth Brower in Palm Bay, and veteran Mike Nicholson, who is from Tampa and is living in Tampa. Let's keep watching. Team Marine, so many incredible stories. One of them, Captain Patrick Nugent from Ohio, who is hoping to do well enough here that he can go to the Invictus Games in 2020 in the Netherlands. But listen to this, in 2017, he was injured, practically paralyzed, immobilized for a couple of years, and here he is in Tampa competing, proving to himself and the world, the sky is the limit. There you heard it, the team forged by the sea, America's Navy. The Navy maintains, trains, and equips combat-ready forces capable of winning wars, deterring aggression, and maintaining the freedom of the seas. Another awesome team here featuring 40 athletes. 6 of them are women, and 5 of the athletes in Team Navy live in Florida right now. Kyle Kozad in Pensacola, Commander Robert Fry in Crestview, veteran Gabriel George in Jacksonville. Also in Jacksonville, Petty Officer, 2nd Class, Mario Ingram. Veteran Daniel Lee lives in Palm Harbor. You're watching these images live here on Spectrum News, and it is remarkable to see the excitement on each of those athletes' faces, those flags waving, and the crowd just going crazy for them. This patriotism, this pride, their smiles, those smiles you see on their faces, are smiles that are the result of accomplishment, because all of these 300 athletes in this year's Warrior Games have been through so much, visible and not visible, but they have all overcome so many challenges. And many will tell you, the times that I've talked to many of these athletes, they will tell you this is not even a competition against each other. This is about competing against themselves as a person and pushing the limits of what their bodies and their minds are capable of doing. Look at that excitement and the cheers and the chants going on the floor of Amalie Arena tonight. There you go. Team Navy, an interesting athlete here. Many interesting stories, but among them is Joe Paternity, who is suffering from PTSD and is here fighting to make sure he can raise awareness for other soldiers, other veterans suffering with mental illness. Team Air Force is in the house, the branch that rules the skies and pushes the boundaries of speed in the defense of our country. We're going to go live right now to the floor as we're watching these amazing heroes take the floor. Our Chris Torello is speaking to somebody in the crowd. Hey, Chris, who do you have?
Yes, I'm actually here with my new friend, Kara, who's from the Bay Area. And you're pretty excited right now because you are an Air Force veteran. How long did you serve?
10 years. I'm so excited to be here.
10 years. And I know you. We were talking a little bit that you've actually had friends who have competed in past Warrior Games. What's it like when you're out at the games watching all of these athletes out there?
It's so amazing. I mean, an event that gets all of us together to celebrate what these servicemen and women have overcome is just, it's such an inspiration.
Yeah. Are you excited for John Stewart and to see all these athletes walking out
Absolutely.
Here?
Absolutely.
All right. Well, Kara, thank you so much for your time and thank you for your service. Really appreciate it. Enjoy your night. Thank you. Veronica, back to you.
Thank you so much. You know, Chris, right now you talk to her and I'm thinking of Kevin Green. He is a staff sergeant we've actually featured on Spectrum News here in the last couple of days. He is in several sports, lives in Melbourne, was born in Brooklyn, and he's on the floor right now. I want you to take a listen to what he told us earlier this month.
It's not that I'm physically incapable to do anything. So that's what I want to display. Like, that's why I feel like these games, the War Games, is a celebration, because I get an opportunity to display what was told to me back in 2015 that I'm physically not able to return to duty. To go out now in 2019, almost 4 years later, to show them that I'm physically able to continue to work. So that's why I'm celebrating. That's why I'm gonna go out on that track, I'm gonna go out on that rowing machine, whatever sport they want me to do, basketball, volleyball, that's what I'm doing as well, and cycling, and show I'm physically able to do these things.
And now our international friends, service members from five different nations coming to Tampa Bay to be part of the 2019 Warrior Games. We're starting with Australia's Defense Force. 24 athletes from down under flying all the way from the other side of the world. This makes perfect sense. For these athletes, this is about being here, showing that they can do anything despite their injuries and the struggles, and also to show support for the U.S. Australia has had a long-standing defense relationship with our country, having fought alongside Americans in every major U.S. military action of the last century. You know, I met some of these athletes just on Thursday during archery practice at MacDill Air Force Base. Earlier this month, we also featured Private Seth McKay, who has an incredible story. You know, he suffered a stroke while on a cruise with his family and was paralyzed on his right side. He could not walk or talk. Let's listen to some of what he shared with us earlier this month.
I wasn't even able to catch a ball last year. You'd throw it at me and I would almost fall over trying to get to it. And to be able to play in a team sport, where as last year I would have just probably just gone off and done my own thing in a wheelchair, not even been part of it, I can now understand that I'm part of a team and I have to do certain things, whereas before I had no understanding of what was even going on.
All right, there you heard from Private Seth McKay. And right now, our attention is turned to the Canadian Armed Forces team walking now down to the floor, getting a whole lot of love from this crowd at Amalie Arena. Our neighbors to the north are here as part of the 2019 Warrior Games. 38 athletes are part of the Canadian Armed Forces team this year. One of them, what an incredible story. Listen to this. Warrant Officer Donna Forster. She was diagnosed not only with multiple sclerosis, but with cancer in recent years. And she says she is competing in the Warrior Games to honor her daughter, who died at the young age of 14. Can you imagine the pain, the struggles? But Donna is here today, and Donna is competing in a number of sports. You know, many of these athletes, many have served several deployments to Iraq and Afghanistan. They suffer from PTSD, and they say they just want to help shine the spotlight on those who suffer silently with mental illness. Let's listen in.
We welcome the Danish Vikings to completely the opposite. opposite climate here in Tampa, Florida. Please give it up for Team Denmark.
We're going to go for more action on the floor to our Dahlia Dangerfield. She is joining us with Congresswoman Kathy Castor.
That's right, Veronica. I'm here with Congresswoman Kathy Castor, who has a front row view of all of this. Tell me, what do you think about the Warrior Games being here in Tampa?
Well, let's face it. This is a patriotic community. There's no better place to have the Warrior Games than right here in Tampa Bay. And like you, I was able to meet some of the competitors backstage. Wow, they have, their spirit just shines through. And for them to bring their spirit to a community that just embraces them, we love our folks who serve at McDill, Team SOCOM, Team CENTCOM, all of our veterans. There's just no better place to stage this competition.
What do you think the value is for our community to have the Warrior Games here?
Really, it's a gift to the Tampa Bay neighbors because it allows us to demonstrate how grateful we are for their service. And a lot of the folks competing in Warrior Games have given a limb, have suffered some injury, but that's not, you can't keep their spirit down. They're wounded warriors, but really, they're just like all of us. With the competitive spirit still alive and well.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Congresswoman Kathy Castor. Veronica, I'm gonna send it back to you with the Netherlands coming down right now.
Great.
And Veronica,
to see.
I should tell you, I met some of these athletes from the Netherlands, and they said they were so excited to be here. And one thing that surprised them the most was that so many people came up to them to say thank you for your service. And they had been serving maybe back in the 1990s, and just for people to come to them and thank them, they said it really, really touched their heart. Veronica?
Absolutely. They all touch your hearts. You really get to know these athletes covering these stories, and it is amazing what they've overcome. We're going to go live to the floor again now to Chris Torello with somebody else in the crowd ready to talk to him. Hey, Chris, who do you have?
To represent the United Kingdom and thank so much for the invite. Ladies and gentlemen.
All righty. Well, thank you very much, Veronica. I'm here with my friend Gabriel. It's a family affair we were just talking about. You came down from Virginia. You have your wife competing. Tell us a little bit about your wife and where she served.
Yes, my wife is Technical Sergeant retired Shantae Gonzalez. She served with the United States Air Force.
And you mentioned to me that she's an ultimate champion. What does that mean for someone who maybe might be new to the Warrior Games?
Yes, ultimate champion is she'll be competing in 8 individual sports. There's 8 events from archery, shooting, swimming, track and field, cycling. It goes on and on,
yeah.
But it's 8 individual sports.
So you guys were up at the USF track and field then, was that correct?
That is correct. Today, I'm proud to say that she placed first in a 100 meter race.
Wow.
And also on the 4x100 in the team as
well. Well, we're gonna be seeing you all at the Tampa Convention Center everywhere throughout the next week. And then it's off to Hilton Head for some R&R, and I think you and your family deserve it. Thank you so much, really appreciate it.
Right.
Thank you much for your time. All right,
thank
Veronica,
you.
We're gonna send it back up to you. I saw the crowd today up at USF track and field. It was amazing. They were cheering on all the athletes. Just an incredible scene up there at USF.
And the incredible scene we're seeing right before our eyes right now with Team UK taking the floor. You can see at least 3 of them athletes have wheelchairs. Listen to this story. Their captain for Team UK is a woman. She is leading that team of 20 athletes. She is 39-year-old George Smith and was just diagnosed a couple of years ago with multiple sclerosis. She says being faced with MS caused her to have a meltdown. She couldn't stop crying, but it was the organization Help for Heroes and its sports recovery program that got her here today. Oh, they are getting so much love. Team SOCOM, based here in Tampa, headquartered at where else? MacDill Air Force Base. SOCOM conducts global special operations and campaigns against state and non-state actors, everything from counterinsurgency to hostage rescue. Team SOCOM is the host team this year, the first time that SOCOM hosts the Warrior Games. So, of course, that's why they're coming out last. Now, those 40 athletes that had the honor of meeting their captain, Clay Pendergrass. In fact, my story with Clay aired today. The man had a near-death experience last year. This is a former Navy SEAL, mind you, who was bedridden for weeks after complications from a spinal cord infection. It was terrible. Today, he is back. He just dropped using a cane in January, but he is better than ever now. Still struggling with a recovery that takes time, but he is strong and he is ready to fight and to compete. But you know what he'll tell you? He's not competing for gold. He is competing to cheer on his teammates after seeing all that they've been through and how inspired he gets by watching them keep going the way they do. Another inspiring story is the one of Master Sergeant Israel Del Toro Jr., the co-captain of Team SOCOM. Listen to what he told us just a couple of days ago.
When I woke up, they gave me the diagnosis of, you know, I'll never walk again. I'll be on a respirator the rest of my life. And I'll be in the hospital for another year and a half. And my military career is pretty much over. 2 months later, I left that hospital walking and breathing on my own.
Just an amazing story. Back in 2005, doctors never thought he would be able to breathe on his own, let alone compete here today. Let's go ahead and take a listen. Official welcome. Everybody's getting very excited where the program goes from here. We're going to see the presentation of colors. We're going to go ahead and stay live with all of that and go ahead and listen in. Let's stand by for that.
Would you please rise for the presentation of colors by the MacDill Air Force Base Ace Honor Guard and the joint mission partners bearing their national colors. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Australia. Ladies and gentlemen, the National Anthem of Canada. gentlemen, the national anthem of Denmark. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the Netherlands. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the United Kingdom. And now to perform the national anthem for the United States, please welcome Major Luis Avila.
Oh, God, you see, Father, on the night, What does a real American warrior look like?
Do you see courage running through their veins? Does determination thrust them into action?
Unconfirmed reports that the official 2019 Warrior Games torch
has been stolen by, well, no one really knows.
Thousands of people are already gathered for those ceremonies at Amalie Arena.
The hunt is on.
Hello? Yes, Mr. President. I'll put our best team on right away. Yes, sir. Hey, Sergeant Major McCauley.
Have we got any SEER-ups from the ground?
Negative, sir.
We need to really consider sending a Delta Force, SEALs, or maybe even the Rangers.
Sir, this is a national emergency. I think you should consider extreme options.
It's Task Force John in the Box.
Hello?
Activate Mission Warrior Games.
I spell Whiskey, Alpha.
Romeo, Romeo.
India, Oscar.
Romeo, Golf.
Alpha, Mike. Echo.
Sierra, how copy?
Yes, copy all, sir. I'm on my way.
Alexa, give me special operations. War Games, command.
Turning on John's man cave.
Don't call it that!
Welcome, John. The torch was last seen in Tampa, Florida. Your training and deployment preparation start now.
We're in this city.
Oh, hey, Mayor.
John, what's up?
Hey, listen, it's a go. Get the team together.
I am on it. We'll go out.
All right.
Yeah.
You cheated, son of a...
All right, sir, I'm gonna need the MQ-9, the Reaper, AC-130, supersized, CV-22. See if they have it in cobalt blue. I would love it in cobalt blue.
Initiating contact bridge with remaining task force members. Titus O'Neill, Lauren Montoya, Luis Vieira.
For many reasons, the food, the culture, hold on. Hey, what's up, Mayor?
Titus.
We got the call.
All right, cool, I'm on my way. I gotta go.
MH-47s with cheese, combat craft medium. Matt,
make it a venti. Do you know if they have a Trans Am? I just the one with the Phoenix on the front. You know what I'm talking about, the T-top.
Analyzing intelligence reports, activating surveillance sensors.
Need more research.
Bam! Woo-hoo! Wah!
Seal delivery vehicle, GMV. And then I'm gonna need probably a Diet Coke, something, maybe a tab.
John, I'm a Lieutenant Colonel.
Oh, I apologize, sir. I didn't realize I was dealing with royalty. You will get me any kind of beverage that I request. Am I clear?
Sir, yes, sir.
Ooh, I didn't see that one over there. Let me have one of those.
All right, sir. Torch has been gone for 4 hours. It could be thousands of miles from here. Give me the egress routes by sea.
And air routes.
Yes. We're gonna need a strike force from the west. The floor. I should not have finished the whole burrito. Where is the torch?
John, sensors indicate no unusual egress activity. Intelligence suggests the torch is still in Tampa Bay.
I'll be flying private.
Hello?
Montoya.
We have a mission.
All right, I'm on my way.
Fill her up, soldier. Premium, unlight it. All right, boys and girls, let's get this torch.
Okay, we have a motion on the floor.
Yes, hello.
Vieira.
Meet the team at McDill.
Let's move out, cupcakes.
Looking for the Warrior Game torch. You hiding something?
Okay. It wasn't me, I swear.
Hey, you!
go for Twinkle Toes.
I've got two suspects, and I believe I have them cornered.
I'm on my way.
John in the box, welcome to Tampa. We've apprehended two suspects. They're right this way.
Let's do this.
This is it. This is the last time I'm gonna tell you.
Stop this! Where's the torch, man?
I'm not telling you.
Tell us where it's at.
Just tell us where the torch is.
I'm not telling you, dude.
Hey, don't you talk to John like that.
Thank you,
John. What about me?
Or Jane. Just tell us where the torch is.
Dad! Dad! It's in the arena.
Say it again.
It's in the arena!
Oh. Mission accomplished, team. Well done. We got it. Right. Nice work, everybody. Yes. Let's go.
He folded like a cheap chair.
Well done, team. Well done. Lauren, get in the arena. Get the torch. I'll hit the stage. You guys go have a beverage. Nice job, everybody.
What is up, Tampa Bay? Welcome, welcome.
How's everybody doing today? Thank you very much for coming out to the Warrior Games. We very much appreciate your support. We've had a tremendous day or two already of competition. The athletes are finding out what it's like to compete in a city that was built inside a humidifier. It's nice. What a lovely climate you have for many of the athletes have taken to growing mushrooms. It's a wonderful. We are excited to be here in Tampa. As I was coming in on the road, I saw the billboards for Tampa, which told me that this is a town that gets in a lot of accidents. And then sues through a personal injury lawyer of some sort, and then uses the money for plastic surgery to fix whatever happened. I have a solution for your town, if you're curious about it. Could help the amount of billboards you have. Why not, when you get the plastic surgery, the next time you get a breast augmentation, just get the airbags put right into them. And when you get in an accident, you'll save yourselves. But we're here to celebrate these unbelievable athletes from all of the branches that we have. And their families are here as well, cheering them on. Give them a nice round of applause as well. Families are the most important thing. I had the honor last year of getting to visit with our men and women overseas in Iraq and Afghanistan. And I traveled on what's called a C-17, which is really, if you've never flown on a C-17, don't. It is truly, they told me, wear layers because it gets really cold and then really hot and then really cold and then really hot and it's really noisy. And so we got over to Afghanistan and we had to go from Bagram Air Force Base to Kandahar. So they moved us from the C-17 to the C-130. And when I got into the C-130, I realized I owe the C-17 an apology. The C-130 is, imagine if you took a can of black olives and dumped out the olives and then just jammed some people inside of there and flew it. And we did, going into Kandahar, what was called the combat landing. You familiar with the combat landing? That's nice that you're familiar with it. I was not familiar with the combat landing. And you know, the pilot of the C-130, he doesn't come on and say,
"Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to plunge straight down."
They just do it. You just farmp. It was frightening. I'll explain to you how frightening it was. Before the combat landing, my beard was brown, and my underwear was white. But the important thing we're doing here today is celebrating our athletes. These are men and women that refuse to allow themselves to be defined by their worst day, but define themselves by their reaction to that day and the resilience and the perseverance and the dedication and the camaraderie and the family. You are going to witness this week a tenacious competition, but you're also going to witness this week camaraderie and family like you've never seen it before. They are all competitors, but they are all now family, and they support each other, and they cheer each other on, and that's what you guys are here for, and I'm so glad you're here. Before we get going, there's a couple of people that wanted to send some messages of congratulations, couldn't be here tonight. Can we have those up real quick on the screen?
I am proud to support our nation's service members and veterans as they compete in the 2019 Warrior Games. Whether they sustain physical or invisible wounds of war while serving our country, these athletes refuse to be defined by their injuries. Instead, their resilience and courage allow them to continue to serve as an inspiration to their fellow citizens. Laura and I thank them for their service and for their continued leadership, and we wish them all the best of luck in the games. May God bless you all.
Hi, I'm Senator Rick Scott. I'm honored to welcome you to the 2019 Warrior Games. Thank you for your selfless service to our nation. Our military members, veterans, and their families make incredible sacrifices to protect our freedom. As governor, I made it my mission to turn Florida into the most military and veteran-friendly state in the nation. And as your U.S. Senator, I will never stop fighting for our men and women in uniform. Thank you and good luck.
Can anyone explain why I look older than George Bush now? How did that happen? How did I age like this? Ladies and gentlemen, as we continue to move things along, please welcome Congresswoman Kathy Castor.
Hi, everybody. I'm Tampa Bay's Congresswoman Kathy Castor, and on behalf of a patriotic community, welcome to the Warrior Games. John, you know, U.S. Special Operations Command is the host here today, and haven't they done a fantastic job of organizing? So, General Clark, Colonel Harbaugh, Chief Master Sergeant Colley, and retired General Thomas, everyone at Team SOCOM, fantastic job. Now, I've met a few of the competitors backstage. They've got steel in their eyes, they've got fire in their heart, and they are ready to compete. We are so grateful that you're here in Tampa, the great Tampa Bay area, to show off your courage, your strength, and your hearts. But just know how grateful we are to each and every one of you and to your families. You inspire us, and we're going to be out there on the sidelines, citizens from all across this patriotic community, to cheer you on and to demonstrate our gratitude. Thank you. You inspire us. Go fight. Go win these competitions, and we're right there behind you. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, John.
Thank you, Congresswoman. Delightful. And now, please welcome the Deputy Secretary of Defense, David Norquist.
I get music. That's cool. Thank you. Good evening. Thank you, John, for the kind introduction, and also thank you for your commitment to the men and women who have served, from your USO tours to support to the Warrior Games. We greatly appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the President of the United States and the Secretary of Defense, I want to start by offering a warm welcome to everyone here today, especially our incredible athletes and their families. It's great to be here in Tampa. It's an honor and a privilege to be able to attend this year's Warrior Games. Today, I had the opportunity to watch the Army basketball team practice, and I have to tell you, Coach Rodney Williams has his three-time defending champions looking pretty good. Where's Team Army? All right. They got specialist Brent Garlick, who was last year's heart of the team, and Staff Sergeant Ross Allewine, who is the defending Warrior Champion Games ultimate champion. Now, don't get cocky, Army. There's a Navy guy behind you who already has 5 gold medals. So, woo! All right, but to you and to all the athletes from across the globe, Canada, Australia, United Kingdom, Denmark, and the Netherlands, thank you. You are truly exceptional. Not only have you served honorably and sacrificed for your country and inspired us all with your tremendous courage as you've embraced and overcome adversity, but you've made it to the Warrior Games. To qualify for the 2020 Olympics, all an athlete needs to do is throw a shot, put over 21 yards, or run 100 meters in 10 seconds. But that's not good enough for the Warrior Games, because to compete in the Warrior Games, it is not enough to be strong. It is not enough to be fast. In the Warrior Games, there is a level of resolve, a unique ability to embrace and overcome adversity that is the price of admission. Just to get to this event, to get to this stage, requires unbelievable grit and resilience. Not only are each of your individual stories inspiring, but collectively, this event is a testament to the quality of those individuals who choose to serve and sacrifice for freedom. You are the finest out there. You are the finest out there, leading by example as you demonstrate great dedication, work ethic, and the determination to triumph no matter the obstacles in your path. We will be forever grateful for your sacrifice and motivated by your example. To close, I'd like to echo the words of a champion athlete that I think embody the essence of the Warrior Games. I may win, and I may lose, but I will never be defeated. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your service, for your sacrifice, and for demonstrating the incredible power of the human spirit. And good luck in the games.
It is true, you know, these athletes have gone through a lot to get here, but nobody gets here by themselves. And I think the families and the caregivers, you know, so often they work just as hard as the athletes to get them prepared and to get them going and to be there. And we have to make sure that we always show our support there as well. I see ya. I see a lot of familiar faces coming up year after year athletes that started maybe their first year a little more tentative, a little more nervous. Now they're in their third year, and they've become mentors to the other athletes and the caregivers and the families. And it's really beautiful to see how it all grows and how that's all paid forward. And our next speaker, I think, plays a huge role in that, in helping the families as they try and negotiate and navigate these new waters. So please welcome to the stage Mr. Ken Fisher. Ken?
Thank you. Hard to believe it's been a year since Colorado Springs, but it's great to be here in Tampa for the 2019 Warrior Games competition presented by Special Operations Command. And once again, I'd like to say thank you to Mayor Castor, the City of Tampa, and the people at SOCOM for being great hosts and for allowing us to be part of tonight's festivities. Before I say another word, I want to say something special, a special thank you to John Stewart, for being here again this year. Year after year, he does such a remarkable job, not only emceeing tonight's event, but by being your biggest cheerleader. There's no bigger supporter of our nation's servicemen and women, indeed all of this nation's first responders, than John. And he does it with no fanfare and a deep passion. Anyone who witnessed his testimony before Congress last week can attest to that deep passion. The only thing I can say is, you ever need a battle buddy, I'm right there with you. One of the great privileges I've had over the last 30 or so years has been serving our military servicemen and women and veterans and their families through my work with Fisher House. And I've had the great honor of meeting so many of this nation's wounded service people, and never a day goes by when I'm not inspired by you, amazed by what you have accomplished, and humbled by the unconditional love and support given to you by your families, your friends, your spouses, your children, by all those who love you the most. Year after year, we in this country have watched with awe as you've overcome obstacles with a fighting spirit and a determination that is seldom seen in this world today. At Fisher House, we see you and your loved ones so early on in the process when things are a little more uncertain and more stressful. Every one of our competitor families knows what it's like to receive that phone call, too often in the middle of the night, informing them that a loved one had been wounded or fallen ill or become injured in some way. Many of those wounds were visible, many were not, and didn't manifest themselves until well after they returned home. We saw so many of your families during those dark and uncertain times, which is why being here is so important to us. Seeing those looks of uncertainty and stress replaced by smiles and happy faces is so gratifying to us. Because at Fisher House, we know that a family's love can be the best medicine of all. To those of you here in Tampa who will watch at home, those of you first-timers, prepare. Prepare to be moved, prepare to be inspired in ways that you never thought possible. I've been affiliated with these adaptive sporting events for almost 10 years, either through Warrior Games or the Invictus Games. I believe in the power of sport as a means to empower individual effort, restore spirit and self-esteem. Sport can so often be the catalyst for those suffering in silence to see what's possible if they're willing to come forward and take that first courageous step. Air Force Master Sergeant Adam Boker is one example. After his Humvee was hit by an IED in Afghanistan, Sergeant Boker was left with severe traumatic brain injury and post-traumatic stress. As with so many families, his wife Brittany noticed he was not the same when he returned home. Adam had totally withdrawn and was on a regimen of some 22 meds a day. After 2.5 years of anger, bitterness, and frustration, he was made aware of adaptive sports and began to train. Though it started slowly, it gradually picked up. And now he spends 3 hours a day training, and his need for meds has dropped to 4 a day. Today he will be the first one to tell you that sports saved his life, his marriage, and his family. And it'll continue to be such an instrumental tool in all of the recoveries. That long journey that so many of you took together, along with your families, whose love and support played such a vital role in getting you here tonight. It gives you a chance to strengthen old bonds and renew friendships for both competitors and their families alike. But in the end, it's the culmination of so many of these long journeys that we celebrate. And once again, thank you. Thank you for your service, for your sacrifice, and thank you for allowing me and the Fisher House family the honor of being part of your celebration. May God bless you all. May God bless those still in harm's way, and may God continue to bless the United States of America. Thank you all.
Please know, anything that everybody up here does or says or works hard on your behalf is because of the inspiration that we get from all of you. You never have to say thank you to anybody because we can never repay you. Just please understand that. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the mayor of Tampa, who and the city has been just so unbelievably gracious and hospitable. Please welcome Mayor Castro.
All right. Thank you, John. All right, welcome, Warrior Games. We are so excited that you are here. We've been waiting for an entire year to get you here in the best city in the nation. And I tell you what, this city is yours this week. We are here to do anything and everything that we can do to make you feel welcome here. As I told you last night, I welcomed you, and you know, with all the athletes, I don't have a favorite, but I was back in the back there, and I understand that SOCOM, my home team, yes, took the silver in golf today, and Canada took the gold, so Canada, all right. Although you are our neighbor, whoa it up a little bit, all right? For the home team, we need to be going home with all of the gold. But anyway, as I spoke to a lot of you last night, I want to say thank you to the families, to all of the support that you are providing. I've spent 31 years as a police officer here in this community, so I know what it means. I know what it means to serve my community. But when you dedicate your life to serving our country and your country, to protect those values and the freedom that we all hold so dear, that is an entirely different level. And I want to tell you that you have my utmost respect, and you have the respect of a grateful community here in Tampa and a grateful nation as well. So thank you. Every single one of you for what you have done. Thank you very, very much. And I hope you have a wonderful week here. I hope the games are wonderful. You go out there and compete and do the best that you can. But what I want you to know is that you are already winners in the hearts and minds of everyone in this nation. So thank you all. God bless you, and y'all go out there and kick some ass this week. Thank you.
That was awesome. We only have 62 more speakers. It's going to really go. It's going to move. You're going to see. It's going to really start to cook. I was kidding. This is your last speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to bring to the stage the man, the myth, the legend. Please welcome General Clark.
Hey, John, thanks for that. Hey, good evening, Tampa. How we doing? Hey, first, let's give another round of applause for the U.S. National Anthem singer, Louis Avila. Wasn't he awesome? Hey, SOCOM is so proud to be sponsoring this Games for the first time. I have to thank my predecessor, Tony Thomas, and his wife, Barb, who are here this evening, who it's their idea to do this here. But then I also have to thank Mayor Castor, who just gave great remarks, and her predecessor, Bob Buckhorn, and the whole city of Tampa for rallying around these Warriors and what you do. There's no better place than Tampa to host these games. Warriors, service members and veterans, are here to participate in these Warriors games. These athletes are coming to a city and a region that continues to put itself on the national stage, and one that welcomes the military with open arms, which is exactly what these athletes, their families, and all those who support them deserves. The Warrior Games were created in 2010 for wounded, ill, and injured service members and veterans to compete in Paralympic-style competitions. The Games showcase the resilient spirit of today's service members from all branches of the military. These athletes have overcome significant physical, behavioral, and prove that life can continue after these life-changing events. I have to echo what Mr. Fisher said for John Stewart and all the things, John, that you have done for these Warrior Games. The video was fantastic. I'm glad I got to play my small role in it, but John, thanks for what you've done and have continued to do for these next 4 years. Anyone who's watched the news lately know that there is a lot going on in the world today. There's a lot of things going on in the Middle East. There's a lot of things going on in Venezuela. But you just had the Deputy Secretary of Defense up here, a few speakers before me. You had the Vice Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, the number two guy in the military, here with us tonight. You had the Vice Chief of Staff of the Air Force. You had the Vice Chief of Staff of the Army that all are here. And they're not here because there's so much going on in the world, but they're here because they realize how important that these games are to the Department of Defense, and they honor your warriors and your families. So thanks to the leadership for being here and recognize how important these games are. The great Vince Lombardi stated, it's not whether you get knocked down, it's whether you get back up. Warriors, not only have you gotten back up, but you're back in the arena. You are competing on a global stage and showing all who witness this event that you are the absolute best with your warrior spirit and your determination. You are showing the American public that we will never quit, and you are representing the best that our nation has. With you, all the U.S. and all the nations are represented here today. Thank you. So to the city of Tampa, thanks again. What I hope is you follow our motto throughout this week. I hope to see you all with fans in the stands throughout the week to honor our Warriors. I'm looking forward to it. Thanks. Good luck, Team SOCOM. Thanks to all of you for being here. God bless this great country. Thank you very much.
The cauldron and the torch for the 2019 Games were designed by Navy veteran Jeremy Evans. His vision for the cauldron is a triangle shape, as you can see. Triangles are the strongest shape, and any weight placed on them is evenly distributed between all three sides. As we all know, the athletes competing in the games show resilience, strength, and adaptability. The triangle represents these three traits. And to begin the torch relay to light the cauldron, she found the torch here at Amalie Arena. Please welcome from SOCOM, Staff Sergeant Lauren Montoya from Tampa, Florida. The torch has been passed to Army Specialist Stephanie Johnson from Arlington, Virginia. The torch now being passed to U.S. Marine Corps Master Gunny Sergeant Carnell Martin from Oceanside, California. The torch now in the hands of Navy Petty Officer Second Class Jay Chun, representing San Jose, California. The torch now passed to Air Force Chief Master Sergeant Garrett K. Kuwanda from Akakilo, Hawaii. Torch now passed to Australia Major Bridget Baker from Canberra, Australian Capital Territory. The torch now in the hands of Canada, Master Corporal Retired Trevor Vautour, Russell, Ontario. The torch now being handed off to Denmark, Danish police officer Dino Messick from Denmark. The torch now in the hands of the Netherlands, Corporal Joey Blocklin, the Royal Netherlands Army veteran from Haarlem, Netherlands. The torch now passed to the United Kingdom, senior aircraft woman Lindsay Kelly from Oxfordshire. Torch is being presented to SOCOM Sergeant First Class Brant Ireland, representing Willow Spring, North Carolina.
first class of Grant Ireland will now pass on the torch to General Clark and Tampa Mayor Jane Kester to light the cauldron. Titus O'Neil also on hand. The 2019 Warrior Games officially have begun!
Ladies and gentlemen, the games have begun. Thank you all so much for your support here today. One more round of applause for our athletes. For our families, for the Tampa community. Hunter Hayes will be out to perform a concert. And until then, I have a selfie tradition to uphold. So we'll see you guys.
What do you say? Look, you're watching Spectrum Big News 9. Our time right now, 8:14. Hard not to wipe tears off your face after watching what just happened here on the floor of Amalie Arena in Tampa. That torch relay was beautiful. This room, this space is so full of patriotism, of pride, of honor. Knowing the sacrifices that all 300 athletes behind me have had to go through, struggles that are still very real for many of them, and here they are competing in the 2019 Warrior Games. You saw some of these athletes involved in the torch relay, some of them missing limbs, walking on a prosthetic leg, maybe pushing themselves in a wheelchair to pass the torch with a fire prior to the cauldron being lit formally. Beginning the games here tonight, the Saturday evening. We're going to go live to the floor right now. Just an amazingly powerful moment. Dahlia Dangerfield and our Chris Torello are both on the floor. Dahlia, I know you have somebody you want to talk to about this amazing event.
Yes, Veronica. I actually have General Thomas here with me. He's actually the one who brought the games to Tampa. He's retired now from SOCOM, but I know that a lot of people want to talk to you. You brought the games here, correct? What do you think?
I assume that Tampa would support it, which was a pretty sound assumption. And I'm so appreciative of how this community has poured out the support for the games. But yeah, I asked, could SOCOM have their turn, and we're lucky to get permission for it.
Why did you think it was important to bring the games here to SOCOM and to Tampa?
Well, we've been participants in the War Games ever since their inception, so we knew how special they were. And I truthfully thought it was our turn. SOCOM's technically not a service. We do everything like a service for our special operators, but we wanted our chance to host them, and we also wanted to showcase this great city.
Now, you've retired, but what do you think about what everyone's done?
This exceeded my expectations, actually. I'm looking forward to seeing the games over the next couple days. I think, you know, we decided to reside in Tampa as well, so I'm a little bit partial.
I know. I was going to say, who are you rooting for? But we already know that.
You know that ahead of time. Yeah.
Well, tell me what this means, the Warrior Games means, to the military community. Why is it so important?
The athletes speak for themselves just by their performance, but the cards that some of these folks have been dealt would have been, you know, just life, not only life altering, but life, you know, ending in some cases, where there was no hope and not a glimmer of, you know, what they could continue to do in the future. And as some of the speakers mentioned earlier, they took it as a setback that they had to recover from, and you'll see over the next couple of days what they do to compete. It always inspires me to work harder and to complain less, because they're the epitome of human resilience.
I guess the fitting of the theme of be inspired, I suppose.
They really are. They walk the walk.
All right. Thank you very much, General
Absolutely.
Thomas.
Thank you.
All right. And I'm guessing you'll be at the games.
As much as I can be. I'll be at every venue.
All right. Thank you, Veronica. I'll send it back to you.
And thank you, Dahlia. Inspired is right. Be inspired is one of the hashtags they're using along with the Warrior Games 2019 to get the word out, to get the community to come out all week and support these athletes. I hear Chris Torello is ready for his interview. Chris, take it away.
Yeah, I actually have one of the athletes here. I'm here with Ben. He traveled from the United Kingdom to be here. You're going to be competing in so many different events. First of all, what did you think of the Warrior Games opening ceremony here in Tampa?
Brilliant walking out. Like, it was one of the best experiences I've had, I think, ever. So, yeah, it was amazing.
And we were just talking. Things are just getting very busy for you because you're going to be competing in so many. You mentioned archery, swimming. Take me through the list of competitions for you.
Archery, shooting, swimming, athletics, volleyball. And I'm sure there's others as well.
There's a lot more.
Wheelchair basketball.
Wheelchair basketball, yeah.
That's me, yeah. Six different sports. So.
Six different sports. You got a little guy here. Who is this with you?
This is Archie.
Yeah.
And then his brother's over there as well, Seb.
Oh, that's wonderful. Well, welcome to Tampa, and good luck, and congratulations. Yeah, you're already here. That's what matters. Cheers, thank you very much. All right, Veronica, back to you.
Thank you so much, Chris. And I want to remind our viewers here on Spectrum News tonight, there is a lot of action happening in the area over the next week. The closing ceremonies are Sunday, but in the meantime, a number of venues in Tampa are hosting these games for free. You can come out, bring the family, show these athletes support. Tomorrow, field, wheelchair tennis, cycling, time trial happening at USF and also Bayshore Boulevard, the site of one of these competitions. This has been our show. What an honor to have been part of it. Thank you so much for watching us tonight here on Spectrum News. More coverage on our websites and social media pages.